is Shelby. I am Grandma. We are going to demonstrate how to make some bows.
I made these two.
Okay. And this is the This is the bow holder that we made for Michaela for her birthday gift. And now we're gonna make her some bows to go on the bow holder.
Which one do I want?
Which one do you want to make first? You want to make a Hello Kitty? I got the ribbon out for that. Or do you want to make a red, white, and blue?
Plus, red, white, and blue since I'm
red, ready. White, and blue? Okay, here's some. We have a bow dabra. This is what we use to make our bows on. It comes with a base and a middle section which has inches and centimeters, which depending on how you measure your ribbon. I use inches. And then I have the wand, which the wand is to help push the ribbon down and make it tighter in the bow dabra. The bow dabra uses a gold colored string. It's not wire, but it kind of works like a wire. And you'll need a clip. And then whatever ribbon you're going to use, I use multiple sizes, any kind of color. She's going to make the red, white, and blue. So I have red, white, and blue, and then a little decorative red, white, and blue colored ribbon.
And then we have also this for these.
You can also add a little bauble, bead, whatever you want to call it, into the center. Hand me that, Shelby. I got a little package of little notions. There's buttons, there's little beads, there's a little rabbit, there's all kinds. This is kind of an Easter theme in here. Oh yeah, it even says Easter grab bag on it. But anyways, they have these little flat beads, which we used on the bottom of these ribbons here as little weights, and we're going to use them on the bows. And you also need a pair of scissors that cuts really good. And a lighter. You need a hot glue gun also, but we won't need that right away.
Little kids, super vision.
Now, your first step is you take a piece of your
wire,
and you put it through the middle, and you tuck one end under one side, and this one will be tucked here, and it'll sit on those two ends. So I just want to cut it, but you put it underneath the bow dabra like that and set it down on it.
So if you don't know, she's a little kid, so you don't need that much of a wire.
And we also have a towel down as a non-skid surface. You can use whatever you're comfortable with. So now you have to decide what you want to use for
as the base.
Your hanging down pieces is what I like to put in first because they're kind of like at the back of the bow. And we have decided with this, right? So fold it in half, then fold it in half again, and don't worry about cutting it at this point. So here's your middle section, and we're going to put that down in the middle of the bow dabra. Make sure you've got it in the middle, and kind of squish it down in there.
If you're
using the skinny white, before you put this in here, if we're using this white, we can take and make it the same exact length as this. Okay. Make it the same exact length just by taking...
Oh, see, it's prettier.
It is very pretty. Just by taking this ribbon and measuring it to the exact length of this ribbon, and then cutting it. And then we'll make nice cuts when we're completely finished.
Wait, with the pretty ones?
So, you want to do the blue or the white on the bottom? These are both just going to hang down. Yes, it doesn't really matter.
It doesn't matter,
So let's put this one back in the bow dabra. And then this one, here's our white, and we did the exact same thing. And let's turn it this way. You can push it down. That gets it in there nice and tight.
So it doesn't fall
out. Okay, so now we can put the blue or the red on the bottom. Which would you like? So what I usually do is I make sure that my tail is going to be the same length.
Oh, I wish I'd use a... I use this one because this one's not pretty.
It is too pretty. Make it the same length as the other tails, maybe a little longer because you're going to be trimming that. And then you kind of fan the middle.
Like, you know how to make a fan.
And you push it down in. And most ribbons that are double-sided, you would give it a turn like this. And I think 3 inches is good, yeah? So this has 3 inches on it. And push it down in. When you push it down in there, you want to give it a twist. And that is so that the pretty side of the ribbon is on the top. All right, measure out to the 3, Shelby.
3, 3, 3.
While I hold this one.
And now we go. Three.
And then you bring it towards me. Like this. You want to keep the pretty side up. All right, hold it there up a 3. Okay, now we push it down in.
And now use this thingy.
And you want to make sure your tail is close to this. Go ahead, push it down with the wand. We're going to call this a wand.
That's a wand. Okay,
now, hold that right there. And then cut your tail just a little bit longer than what you want it.
You don't have that.
Okay, now the white. Let's get the white, and I like to use a pin to hold my ribbons in place.
Just take a little pin. No, that's not.
And go like this.
That was for the white.
It's okay. Now for the white.
This white.
Do the same thing we did with the blue. You have the pin. Okay, so we're going to take this ribbon, and again, make it for the tail. And when you get to the middle, you're going to twist at the middle, like this. All right, shall we turn it up? Make sure it's 3 inches over there. Over here. When you get it to the center, give it a twist. Okay.
And then you stuck in my hand now.
Bring it over here. Okay, you bring it towards the middle. Sorry. Push it down in. Okay, put the wand in. Wait a minute. Let's make this a little longer. Okay, push it down in there. Okay. Alright. Now, the tail. I'll give it another snip over here until we're done. Okay. You can let go of that. Just let it sit there. And then the next color, I hope there's enough red.
Yeah, it feels thick.
Oh, that looks like there's a lot of red on there. Let's put our straight pin.
Oh, this one's bent.
Our straight pin holds our ribbon in place.
There you go.
All right.
A bent pin.
A bent pin. Now we're going to do the red.
And now
we're going to start over here.
A little longer.
Put it down in.
There. And this needs to be
There's no specific side to the red, so just measure out to the 3.
And
bring it over. Let me see this. Okay. Put that down in there.
And now the other side.
The 3. Okay, bring it to the middle.
And now go that button.
And then we gotta bring this down. Okay. Now push that down in. Alright, now let's trim the end here. Alright, you can let go of it for a second while we get our ribbon put back together. We've got it all pushed down. Now here's the tricky part.
What?
And make sure it's pushed down enough. Push it down really good. Now what you want to do is you want to keep, I kind of hold it in the middle like this. You want to get your 2 ends, get your other end, Shelby. Bring it up to the top. And then tie it. Tie it. Tie it really tight. Okay, now do it one more time. Okay, now you can pull your bow off of the bodabra.
Oh,
there we go. Now set your bodabra aside. And now is your time to move your little ribbons around and make sure they're how you want them before you really give it a good tie. Make it nice and tight. So I think everything looks pretty good. Yeah?
No.
Okay. Now I usually take the strings and bring them to the back and tie again because it's still loose. We want it nice and tight. And give it another tie. It did. I'm sorry. And then maybe even one more time to the front. Do it twice. You want to make sure it's nice and tight. You don't want it to come apart.
See, that's mine didn't come apart.
Don't worry about the gold showing because we're fixing to cover it. You trim the strings
with this.
With your scissors. And I like to take a little bit of hot glue. I like to take a little bit of glue and put on the top of the knots that we made. Just to make sure they aren't going to come apart. Now we're going to cover up this gold in the middle. Because you don't have a little bead. Oh, you got it?
Yes.
You can do something else. Now, to me, this is the front of the ribbon where this red is. And then you have the blue and the white, and you have your little strings hanging down. So this is the back. Put this up here. Put a little drop of glue right there. And then put your end of your ribbon in there.
This one's see-through, so it's going to be way harder because...
So you're going to wrap this around until it goes to the back. And then glue it down. And then you would take your little bead and put your bead on the top here. And then that would cover everything. But if you don't have a little bead, you can take and measure your ribbon around and cut just a little bit extra. Doesn't matter, however much you're comfortable with. And this is where the front, and make an overhand knot. Before you tighten it down, make sure it's going to end up right in the middle of your ribbon. And you know what? I think I might leave that there because in case that little bead should fall off, it will be covered. Okay? So then you put another little drop of glue and you put your other piece of ribbon down.
And if you want, because your hand is getting burnt, you get a toothpick.
So, there you have it. You would have this little knot as the decoration to cover your string.
And this year, I will be wearing this bow for July 4th. If you do something fun, I will be wearing this bow.
Okay, so now you want to take...
And we will bring you with us.
Take your clip. This is your clip. And I always open it up. I'll put that on in just a second. I always open it up and I take the hot glue and I make sure I know where I'm going to be putting this. It's going to be going right across here, kind of in the middle. So then you put the glue on the clip like this, however much you think you need. And you put your bow on there. Arrange it how you want it on the clip.
Yes.
Then to finish it up with the little bead. Alright, so now you want to take your little bead.
The little bead.
Put a little bit of glue on there.
Okay.
And put your bead on there like this. And there you have your bow.
My bow.
Now, before you're done, you got to finish up your ends. And to finish up your bow, we've got our bow all on our little clip. You want to take the ends of your ribbon, however you want to finish them. I like to cut at an angle. This one is already at an angle. Like that. And then you take your lighter And you just kind of wave it over the end. And that is to keep it from raveling.
It's not straight.
This one's already at an angle, so we'll go like that.
Why do you like an angle?
I don't know, I just think it's pretty. You can do an angle or you can do a V shape. And then here's our white one that hangs down. You just cut that right there.
And we don't cut those at the angle.
Oh yeah, at an angle. What, you want them at an angle? They don't have to be. They're the whole
ones. Mine's not at an angle, none of mine.
And then here's your other two. We won't even need to cut these.
I don't put mine at an angle because I don't.
Okay, now let's do the other side. And this is adult supervision, definitely, with the lighter, I would say.
I would think that the adult should just do it.
You think the adult should just do it?
Adult, just do it.
And here's this one.
What about this one?
I haven't gotten there yet.
We have to go really quick with the see-through ones because they don't.
Yeah, they did, didn't they? They went really quick. We have to kind of, yeah, be careful of your ribbon because if they are like this white one, you're just heating up the little bit on the ends so they don't ravel. That's all you're doing. The blue. This is the last one. At an angle. The measurements are, like I said, when you put it on your bow dapper, use your inches on here to measure your ribbon and then cut. Don't cut before.
Well, if you use setting needles,
you can use the other size. But here's the pretty red, white, and blue bow. Mm-hmm. And it would go in, like she has on a side ponytail, we could put it on the side and then have the ribbons hang down like this. Or if you have it in the back, it could go there and hang down. Poof! You're so silly. Anyways, this is our instructions on how to make a bow. We're going to finish up making a bunch of bows and we'll come back and show you all the bows on the bow holder that we made for Michaela's birthday.
Some flowers, ribbons, and then some bows, and then some little ribbon.
Yep, that's our finished product. I took some pictures of every bow, and it'll be on the video to show exactly what we did.
Yeah.
If you enjoyed our video from Family of Fun on how to make a bow, like, comment, share, subscribe, and
ring the bell!
Ring that bell for more notifications from Family of Fun. Goodbye, all our fun friends. Bye.
Bye.